Finally, we were all wondering when it was going to happen. DJ Lemahieu has finally gotten re-signed by the New York Yankees. Everyone, welcome back to another video. I don't know what it is with the MLB lately, but it seems like almost every video I've had lined up recently has been shifted or moved around on my content schedule because, deals are finally getting done. It's so weird. I had a Lemahieu video lined up for this weekend. No kidding. No joke. And he gets signed today. But no problem. There's no problem of the matter. So we're going to be covering DJ Lemahieu's signing today. So here it is. MLB's Twitter. DJ Lemahieu is coming back to the Yankees. He's back. Reported by ESPN's Jeff Passan. I believe that if we go back here, yeah. Jon Paul Morosi, I believe, was first on the deal. He tweeted very early, a little after 5 a.m. this morning, that DJ Lemahieu and the Yankees were coming near, they were discussing a deal and they were going to be finalizing an agreement likely today. And they did. If we go ahead and go back, the deal is a six-year deal worth an estimated $90 million. And now I'm over here on MLB.com. This was a report by MLB.com's Brian Hawk. This is his article. This is his report. And a lot of people are saying that, man, geez, 6 years, $90 million for DJ Lemahieu, who's 32 years old. That's kind of a, you know, that's a rough deal. He's going to be 38 by the end of this contract. Well, DJ Lemahieu, in the last two seasons, he has had a .336 batting average, a .386 on-base percentage, and is slugging .536. This is in nearly 200 games with the Yankees over the past two seasons. He led the AL in batting average in 2020 with a .364 batting average. He also led on on-base percentage at .421 and OPS, which is on-base plus slugging, over 1,000. He is, and he also finished third in the AL MVP voting. And then he had a fourth place finish in 2019. I kind of just briefly want to go through some things just quickly on, because you know, when DJ Lemahieu early on, in the free agent market, there was a lot of talk that DJ Lemahieu was, he was being passed on and he was being very impatient with the Yankees on a re-signing. You know, obviously they went ahead and got the deal done today, 6 years, $90 million. But prior to today, there was a lot of talk that Lemahieu was impatient and he was ready to be signed. And, I think it's warranted. A lot of players, don't get me wrong, a lot of players overvalue themselves on the market. A lot of players think that they're worth a lot more money than they actually are. Talking real digits here in real life, you know, they overvalue themselves. I think DJ Lemahieu was not one of those guys. You can see a lot of people get signed for a lot more money than him that just don't have the output like he has had. Now, what do I mean by that? Let's show you the numbers to back up that statement. You know, you say, what numbers? What are you talking about? Here is his numbers. Career and lifetime. Let's look at that right down here. I'll zoom in whenever I go to edit this video. Lifetime career average, .305. He is batting over .300 lifetime. And this is over, what, he's been in the league for 10 seasons now? Let's go ahead and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, 10 seasons, and he's batting over .300. Now, a lot of people think, oh, what are you talking about, Wes? You know, he had, what, 7 seasons with the Rockies. And, you know, everybody, there's always this statement in baseball that it's easier to hit in Colorado due to the high elevation. The ball just travels there, which is true. That's very true. You know, a lot of people can hit more home runs in the average season if they're a Colorado Rocky. I get that. But, you know, he had his rookie season with the Chicago Cubs, and then in the last two seasons, he's with the New York Yankees, and he has been extremely consistent. What do I mean by that? He has been extremely consistent, and he's been there. Let's look at this. In 2020, in a shortened season, he played in 50 games. He only missed 10 games. 2019, 145. That means he only missed what? 17 games? 128 games in 2018. Okay, he had a little bit of, you know, he struggled a little bit with staying on the field. 155 games. He's, point being, he's been on the field for over 100 games for over half of his career. You know, he's consistently there day in and day out, and he's getting the job done. It's pretty obvious he's had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 seasons and almost 6 seasons batting over 300. The guy gets on base, guys. I mean, he is worth this money. He's worth the 6 years at $90 million. I would have liked to see him go to somewhere else other than the Yankees, just because I'm a real fan of DJ LeMahieu, and I think the Yankees are really overpowered already as it is. That's just me. It seems like they always have the money and they always get the top premier players because they always have money. Never seems to be a problem with the Yankees, and that's just historically speaking, they always sign the top players because they're always able to feed out the most money to them. Until, of course, they hit the luxury tax, then it finally becomes a problem. But before then, they just throw money out the window like it's nobody's business. Something that's interesting that's kind of tied to this video is we'll see what happens with Colton Wong. Been really interested on him. Probably have a video on him tomorrow. I was planning on having a Colton Wong and DJ LeMahieu video tied together. A second base, like almost like a second baseman's free agent market video with them, you know, bundled as a package. But it'll be interesting to see where Colton Wong goes, because the DJ LeMahieu signing today will definitely impact his market. Absolutely it will. A lot of the people and a lot of the teams that were interested in LeMahieu, they didn't get him today. You know, he went to the Yankees, and so next one on that list is Colton Wong. So we'll see. I'm very interested to see Blue Jays, Braves, who else did I say earlier? Red Sox. We'll see if you know, Colton Wong's name's kind of floating around. I bet the Blue Jays for sure will be in that conversation. Thank you for watching this video. That's going to do it for this video, guys. Do have a few other videos lined up for today, so stay tuned. I will be uploading more. This won't be the only video of the day. Stay tuned. Wasn't expecting LeMahieu to get signed, but hey, great deal for a great player, and I'm glad that he got his money. For now, until the next one, Tabor timeout. Peace.